My dad grew up on a farm in northeast Iowa in the 1950s. There's a lot we don't know about our parents' childhood, but after my father had a heart attack, I realized I didn't want all of that to be lost. So I asked him to show me where he grew up.
Well, it's knowing that your door is always open and your path is free to walk. That makes me tend to leave my sleeping bag rolled up, stashed behind your couch. And it's knowing I'm not shackled by forgotten words and bonds and the ink stains that have dried upon some lines. That keeps you in the back roads by the rivers of my memory and keeps you ever gentle on my mind.
The farm was first settled in the mid-1800s by Irish immigrants, the Magner brothers.
They reminded of Ireland, that's why they liked it. It was just like Ireland, with the trees and everything. But you can see how that was leveled. That isn't leveled, that isn't leveled. That was leveled right there. That's where he got his cabin. All fell down. And then they moved up the hill.
How old were you when you got running water in the house?
I was 19, 20.
So you lived your whole childhood without running water?
Never, I couldn't bring friends out. I brought them one time and they said, where's the bathroom? Mother said, well, we have a basin out here and a den, but the bathroom's outside. I never did bring them back out again. There were some girls and guys. I know they're embarrassed. Cornco, we used to climb up there and jump off it, and Grandma Magnus says, you'll ruin your arches and your feet. Don't jump. We thought it was cool to jump. Boy, there used to be nothing but trees down here. This is one time when it was underwater. The oceans were around here. See? Some kind of creatures, or sea creatures maybe. Boys brought our cousins down here. We call this the first fall, and then the waterfalls. Look at that. We go underneath and the water is so cold.
Do you think it has a distinct flavor or taste?
I think it does.
Well, how did they get water up to the house from down here?
It came from that pipe. It came from that pond. The pipe ran over to there, tied to a tree, and ran down here. It worked on its own. 90% of the water shot out, 10% went up the hill. It was free energy. I rode my horse on the other side. I thought that was great. Our cousins would come down, and they'd sit here and sunbathe. And then they'd get their feet cool. My cousin Ruth Ann Clausen, they'd sometimes sit right down the water.
I remember you and I walking down here, because Grandma sent us to get apples. She wanted to make a pie. We brought her a basket.
And they sent me down to get the calf, and I couldn't carry the calf, so I went back home, and I got the horse, and I got a gunny bag, and I took the calf, and I put him over her back and tied his feet together under. She stood and let me do that. And the cow bellowed, and I took her all the way home. Put the calf in the barn. Grandma said, I really did good. As I seen on the Lone Ranger or someplace. I told kids at school, and they didn't believe me.
Pretty lucky kid that gets to grow up with a playground this big.
Yeah, we never had no toys, we had to walk. But that makes you receptive a lot better. I used to be able to run from here to the house and never stop running. I always used to think this was enchanted. Stopping and seeing some fox, and there was deer down there and everything. I lived down there because it was warmer in the winter. I killed my first chipmunk down here. I took it home and Grandma said, you know, feed it to the cats. She said, no, chipmunks ain't good for nothing. They little rodents. I said, yeah. But I shot one. I thought I was a big hunter.
So when did you get electricity in the house?
The electricity long before they had any plumbing. Grandma said she had lanterns, and then when the neighbors and everybody got electric lights, then the day extended and they could do stuff at night. And Grandpa fell and broke his leg. or a horse fell on him or something. Then a neighbor came over and they all helped Grandpa. He just died not too many years ago. He told me about it one day. His name was Arnie Ansager. Lorraine knew it. She said he used to stay at the house. That's pretty here. It's nice.
You're out here by yourself.
Okay. Blue eyes. He fell out of the barn. Don't fall out again. This is where Carrie was helping one time and the bumblebee started stinging him. And I towed him to Larry. Larry took him, put mud on him and stuff.
It was a 2 mile walk to school.
Schoolhouse Lane, that's what this is called. And then some days the teacher felt sorry for us and the rain she'd give us right up to the top. We used to play in the woods down here, play fort. Oh, that was fun. And that's why Ryan used to farm this. Sometimes we walked across country to his fifth place and she'd give me a sandwich. School sat up here. Oh, this is remote. There was a field back there, just a little field. And deer would come up, and we see deer, and teachers say, kids, put your books down, look at the deer. 8 grades, 20-some kids.
And so is that where your dad went to school?
Yeah, I went to school there too. 5th grade, they closed all the country schools. Not all of them, but this one, we had no electricity. So they closed, the bus picked us up. They call it consolidation. Rural consolidation. We'd walk in a gravel road, and the cars would come by so fast and throw rocks, and Frank and I'd get down the ditch. And one time a school bus went by, and Frank threw a rock at the school bus. He said, do you boys ever throw rocks again? He said, I'm telling the sheriff. And somebody did call to tell mother.
About a mile down the road from the farm is the Westridge Church, Meeting Hall, and Cemetery.
This guy established the farm, see? Well, this is my grandpa. And John, they got a church window in there. He's the one who donated this land for the cemetery. That was his farm. All his farm there. Maybe 200 acres too. I remember one time Grandma Magner's, or Grandpa Magner's car wouldn't start. And Grandma says, we got to go to church. So he got the tractor out. And we ran up in the barn and throwed down some hay. And Grandma went and got some blankets. And we all sat, and Grandma brought us up in the wagon. And we all sat in there. People looked. But that was in the 50s. We were little. Grandpa drove the tractor, and here we come.
I'll put that black Iowa dirt on a biscuit. I'll put that black Iowa dirt in my tea. I'll put that black Iowa dirt in a big old bucket and I carry it around with me. Well, I took a walk in the cornrow this morning. Last night it rained an inch or two. Well, it was getting hard to walk. I looked down at my feet. I got that black Iowa dirt on my shoes. Well, I got that dirt underneath my fingernails. I got that dirt running through my veins. Oh, that black Iowa dirt turned my blood to mud. Every time it rains, oh Lord, every time it rains. And in the east field, I got me a little rye patch. And in the north field, I got my corn. And up on high ground, where I'll be found. The house where I was born. And I've seen black Iowa dirt help a family get by on a wing of prayer. And I've seen black Iowa dirt explode out the ground and go 1,000 feet in the air. Well, I got that dirt underneath my fingernails. I got that dirt running through my veins. Oh, that black Iowa dirt turned my blood to mud. Every time it rains, oh Lord, every time it rains. I got me a big old patch of taters. I got me a big old patch of beans. I got that black Iowa dirt on my new white shirt. Got that black Iowa dirt on my jeans. Well, I put that black Iowa dirt on a biscuit. I'll put that black Iowa dirt in my tea. And when they go to fill my grave,
hill. They'll put that black Iowa dirt over me, oh Lord, black Iowa dirt over me. Well, I got that dirt underneath my fingernails. I got that dirt running through my veins. Well, that black Iowa dirt turned my blood to mud every time it rains, oh Lord, every time it rains.